water sports come free, so you can really indulge yourself. What a holiday so far.
Goodbye. No.
But there's more to Koh Samui than tourism. I met someone high up in the coconut business.
They're quite difficult to get off, aren't they? It's having to twist them.
Yes.
Yes, it has to get past the dead wood as well to actually get to the coconut.
A few up there, I hope they don't fall on their heads.
Oh, it's hot. You must keep drinking in this heat, you know, especially wearing that coat. Well, the temptation would be to stay in the hotel all the time, but you can't come all this way and not see the rest of the island. First stop for most people is the island's best known landmark, the Big Buddha Complex. Until you move inland that you start to get a feel for island life as it was before the tourists arrived. And with a little luck, you'll come across some of Koh Samui's hidden treasures. Another landmark on the island is Hin Tar, or Grandfather Rock. For some reason, this strange rock formation attracts visitors who find its unusual shape amusing. The coast at Chiao Weng is a stretch of beach with a much busier atmosphere, due mainly to the row upon row of bungalows stretching back up to the main street. During the day, it's a chaotic collection of cars, motorbikes and people, but at night, well, it's just the same, but with a wealth of stalls and bars accompanied by a continuous thumping soundtrack. I asked Andrew, the assistant manager at the hotel, to be my guide.
And here's our Mr. Pancake Man.
Hello!
You can pick a pancake, right? And he fills it up with all your ingredients.
Thank you very much. Thank you. Next, a touch of Thai street theatre.
See these girls over here?
Yeah?
In fact, they're not girls at all.
You're joking?
No, they're guys.
They're beautiful.
I know.
Oh, will
I
you
know.
Take a photograph with
sure, why not?
Oh, thank you. Oh my goodness! Spot the difference! One of the attractions for coming here at the moment must be the favourable exchange rate. Translated to the price of the food, a seafood platter with all these gorgeous lobsters and crabs, £2.50. If, however, you'd rather watch the sea life than eat it, there are plenty of dive schools to cater for you. Even if you don't dive, it's worth taking a boat out to An Thong National Marine Park. This cluster of 41 small islands was once a haven for pirate junks, and here on Sleeping Cow Island, you can climb to the peak for a better view.
Only another 3 miles. Worth it.
So if it's a pretty setting you're after, you don't have to leave the hotel. For many years, independent travellers have enjoyed the cheap beach hut style accommodation here in Koh Samui. Well now, with hotel resorts like this one, you can enjoy this paradise island with a little more comfort. And I'm all for that. You can find simple beach accommodation from around £10 a night. But if you're like me and want a touch of luxury, then this package combines 9 nights at the Santabri Dusit on Koh Samui with 3 nights in Bangkok from £1,369. That's with British Airways Holidays.